Alright, well, I figure I'd throw up another video. Well, you see it. It's cold outside. The garage door is open. But let me show y'all what I'm up to. Alright, so went to the junkyard this morning. Went and grabbed something I ain't never had. A damn trunk popper. But the car I took it from was a Pontiac Fiero. Dash was tore up in it. I didn't even care to break my phone out. It was 12 degrees out there in that junkyard. Toes was freezing, hands was freezing, but I got the solenoid to pop the trunk. And as you can see, now I got a trunk popper. And I'm going to install it in a location that makes sense to me, because I never saw the point of a trunk popper being in the glove box. So let me show you what I got here. Let's pull this out. So here's the button that I got, but I'm gonna find a, well, I know where I'm gonna put it. That'll be another video. But yeah, got me a trunk popper now. All the cutties that I'd have never had, never had one, so now I got one. But yeah, so it is what it is. This phone right here.
Hey.
Right here. Come here. Hold it right here. No, you're doing too much. Hold it right here. Hold it. Don't cover the camera up. Hold it. No, right there.
What are you supposed to expect me to do? Hold on. Don't start this car.
I'm not starting it. Is it light come on?
Yeah.
Any lights come on?
No.
No white ones?
No. What are you expecting me to do?
So, I asked on my Instagram if anybody knew how to wire these up, and injected Cuddy and my homie the left god, they helped me out. So I'm gonna throw that in this video. And now let me shut this garage. It's cold as hell. Let me see. I'll show you what I did to wire up my reverse lights. Let me let that close. Well, I'm going to show you what I did to wire up the reverse lights with the B&M shifter. Alright, so this is what I did. There's a plug that's on this little white thing that's on your steering column. Alright, so let me see. I took this off right here, removed this, and I threw some spade connectors in there to get it to you know, just to connect or whatever. So when you're looking at the little micro switch, all right, this one right here, well, I don't even know if it really matters which one or wherever, which one goes to what. So don't even pay attention to that part. But I unplugged it, took the little, I guess you could say decapped it or whatever. I don't know what the correct term is, but took the little black piece off of it. Do some spade connectors on here. Yeah, so now with my shifter, I have reverse lights. I didn't want to cut any corners because I actually paid for these ones, because they go with this style of tail light. So I had to have it. So it is what it is. But yeah, so I'm gonna throw that in this video. Might just add that with it, or I could just show y'all. I just might add it with it. It's too much time to unbolt this again. So yeah, I gotta clean up some wiring and all that. Clean up some wiring, and I could throw, I got a couple of nicks on my console when I was removing it. I gotta paint it up again. but clean up some wiring. I don't think I did, but I also got a trunk popper now, so I'll add that in the video. And yeah, give you guys a little update of little knick-knack things I've been doing since it's cold as hell outside. So for my next magic trick, get this line or this wire down the side of this. So what I did is put a hanger in there and about to see if I can pull it through and get lucky. So be right back. All right, so that worked. Fed that through. So now what I gotta do is, you know, get my slack right. Zip tie this on here. Get my wire ran through. Try to come through where them speaker wires is at. Yeah, good to go.